Hello, it's me, Luigi, and welcome to LEGO Luigi Explores the Human Body. Today, we're gonna look at the circulatory system. That's right. Now, Luigi told me that I have an important role to play in today's episode. I don't know what it is yet, but he said it was important, so I'll keep my ears open. Hey, Mario, isn't it time for your daily toll, Daddy? Oh, you're right. Thank you for reminding me. I'll try and be back before too long. The circulatory system is our body's own special delivery system, and it consists of the heart, the blood vessels, and the blood itself. With the exception of pulmonary vessels in the lungs, the blood vessels shown in red are arteries, which carry blood away from the heart, and the blue ones are veins, which carry blood back to the heart. In addition to arteries and veins, there are also really small blood vessels called capillaries. These are like bus stops, where the bloodstream picks up and drops off passengers. The passengers could be anything. Oxygen, nutrients from the food we eat, waste products, you name it. Hey, didn't you already talk about that in a previous episode? Well, yes, sort of. I did say how blood is mostly water and that it brings liquid waste to the kidneys to be disposed of. Blood is a very major part of the body, so I'll probably talk about it again in future episodes. Oh hey, before I forget, what is it that makes blood red? I'm getting there. I was just about to describe the composition of blood. Ooh, this I've got to hear. The following diagram should clearly illustrate the basic composition of your blood. Around 45% of it is erythrocytes, more commonly known as red blood cells. A mature red blood cell is usually disc-shaped as it has no nucleus. Red blood cells carry oxygen from the lungs to the rest of the body, and then they carry carbon dioxide back to the lungs. The hemoglobin in red blood cells is what makes your oxygenated blood red. When it's in your veins and pulmonary arteries, your blood is dark red, but it turns bright red when you bleed because of the oxygen in the air. The yellowish part you see is plasma, which makes up about 55% of blood. As we mentioned in the episode about the urinary system, plasma is the liquid part of our blood, and it's mostly made of water. The rest of it is stuff that's dissolved in the water, such as proteins, hormones, electrolytes, and waste products, like urea. Exactly. But what about that whitish part in the middle? That's the buffy coat. It's made up of white blood cells and platelets. White blood cells keep you healthy by fighting infectious germs, and platelets are broken up pieces of cells that form clots to stop you from bleeding. The buffy coat makes up less than 1% of your blood. Good to know. Well, I've got to go now. Bye. Let's talk about blood type now. Your blood type is determined by cell markers called antigens. Your immune system doesn't like it when it sees an antigen it doesn't recognize. Red blood cells have two types of antigens. One of them determines whether you have type O, A, B, or AB blood. Type AB, the universal recipient, has both A and B antigens, while type O, the universal donor, has neither. The other type of antigen determines your blood's Rh factor, that is, whether your blood type is positive or negative. If you have Rh antigens, you're positive, otherwise you're negative. Blood type is important to keep in mind if you're going to give or receive blood. You don't want to introduce foreign antigens into the bloodstream. Hey, wait! Come back! My heart bleeds for you! Well, that was unexpected. Speaking of the heart, let's take a look at it right now. The human heart is divided into four chambers, two atria and two ventricles. Each of the chambers of the heart are separated by valves, and the left and right sides of the heart are divided by the septum. When you hear or feel your heart beating, that's the valves in your heart slamming shut. It's just the same when you check your pulse, because your veins have valves in them too. Excuse me, can you help me catch that pinkle that just ran by? Sorry, I can't. I'm busy with an educational video. Okay, thanks anyway. The cycle starts here, in the right ventricle. This heart is shown from the front, so when I say left and right, that would mean your left and your right if this were your own heart. From the right ventricle, deoxygenated blood is given a big pump through the pulmonary arteries to capillaries in the lungs, where it drops off carbon dioxide and picks up oxygen to take to the rest of the body. Then the pulmonary veins send oxygenated blood back to the left atrium. After that, pressure changes send the blood to the left ventricle, where it's given another big pump through the largest artery, the aorta, to the rest of the body, where your various organs get their share of oxygen and get rid of carbon dioxide. Deoxygenated blood then travels through the veins to the two vena cava, which lead to the right atrium, which leads right back into the right ventricle where it started. Hey Luigi, I was just sauntering by when I noticed that you forgot to say three things. What are those three things I forgot to say? First of all, you forgot to say how much blood we have circulating around our bodies. Of course, the average adult has around 5 liters of blood, while a child has only 3. Okay, second, if you strung all your blood vessels together, how long would it be? It would be 60,000 miles long. That's long enough to circle the Earth nearly 2.5 times. And third, isn't the heart the strongest muscle in the entire... Oh, Mario, you're back early. Well, I realized I was out of Toad Rally tickets, so I can't do a Toad Rally today. Now, what was the important thing you were going to have me do? I was going to have us compare heart rates, but since you didn't run, I guess we won't be doing that. Ugh. Mario, you scared the shell out of me. I think you mean he scared you out of the shell. Hey, you can compare heart rates with that Koopa. Oh yeah, exercise isn't the only thing that can boost your heart rate. No, you don't need to do that. Take my word for it. My heart's beating pretty fast for a turtle. How can you be a turtle if you were removed from your shell unharmed? Hey, this is an anatomy show, not a zoology show. He's right, you know. When you need more oxygen to power your muscles because you're exercising or stressed, your heart beats faster to get that oxygen to your muscles faster. That's right, Mario. If you need to get somewhere quickly, your heart sends blood to your muscles faster. Oh yeah? Well, there's somewhere I need to get quickly. Where? Out of here! Hey, you forgot your shell! Well, this episode ended on a very weird note. I'll say, whatever. Thanks for watching, everybody. Make sure to like and subscribe to Luppet Central for more videos of me and Bowser's helpers. The links to the research sources for this episode are in the description below. See you next time! You know you can get Toad Rally tickets from the bonus game house, right?